fans, as you know by now, WCW's own Midsummer Classic is Bash of the Beast. The event this year is Sunday, July 12th from the Cox Arena, San Diego, California. Tickets available at the Aztec Box Office and Ticketmaster. And our Midsummer Classic just got to be the biggest one ever. It's official. Diamond Dallas Page and the Mailman Karl Malone will be a tag team against Dennis Rodman and Hollywood Hogan. You saw Dennis. You saw Jay Leno last night, the tag team with Jay Leno. When Karl Malone came out showing the bulging biceps of his, he looked awesome, and the man was dead serious. I know Leno was trying to have a lot of fun with it, but Malone was serious about Rodman, about Hogan. Of course, we know how serious DDP is.
And Karl Malone looks like he's physically ready. You're not kidding, Tony. He's ready for the squared circle, and he's going to get that opportunity to shine. Upcoming Bash at the Beach right around the corner when he joins Diamond Dallas Page. What a combination that's going to be.
Well, they're all four gigantic, huge men, but it's going to be very interesting, like you say. And what Leno did, I could see he was scared. He wanted to make light of it, hoping it would go away. But this thing isn't going to go away.
Returns to action after a lengthy absence here in World Championship Wrestling. He brings in the same demeanor. You know, we talk about tough men in our sport. Certainly, Steve McMichael's at the top of the list.
Absolutely, Tony. He has been sidelined for the past couple of months with a broken arm suffered at the hands of the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith. But this man, who never missed a National Football League game in his NFL career, was forced to the sidelines by World Championship Wrestling. They forced him to take that time off. He did not want to. He has been dying to return, and the man who played for years through pain is set to return to the ring tonight on Thunder.
I asked him, I said, how much pain were you in? He said, you always play in pain. I always have pain. I have pain when I get up, pain when I go to bed. That's how I live.
And for Mongo McMichael, he played with pain, was willing to, but as you said, Mike, certainly was forced by WCW. And you see Mike Enos, what he's doing. The arm heavily taped, heavily bandaged, and Enos is going right for it here.
Well, there's no secrets in the locker room, that's for sure. And Mike Enos is one smart individual, focusing his strategy in the early going on the previously injured hand of Steve Mongo McMichael. Let's see how that hand is going to be able to stand up to the pain and punishment inflicted by Mike Enos.
Well, even though he's got the okay to wrestle and it's taped heavily, it's still tender. It's got to be tender. And Enos, being the smart man he is, going right for it and taking advantage of it. That's what I do.
Well, even though this is his first return as a wrestler, he made a shocking appearance Monday in Uniondale, Nassau Coliseum, on WCW Monday Nitro when he came out to help Chris Benoit. When Benoit was attacked by Stevie Ray, when Benoit gave a turn to the cameras and was showing the people the side of the horseman, the fans, of course, at the Nassau Coliseum erupted. Back to the days of the horsemen, where Mongo and Benoit were certainly a big part of that group. And I'm not so sure if Mongo is, do you think he's come back too early here? I don't know. He's in a lot of pain early on in this matchup. Maybe he should have taken a little bit more time off.
Well, he certainly hasn't been able to get untracked against Mean Mike Enos. Enos has been in total control from the opening bell. And he continues to work over the head. Slamming it again against those steel ring steps.
Well, he should know, too. You come in the ring with an injury like that, you got it taped. You only got one arm taped. It's a target. It's a bullseye. Enos has to go for it. It just makes sense.
Well, I tell you, in this case, it didn't matter taped or not, because everyone knew about the arm. They knew what arm it was. They could have taped the other arm. I think Enos would have still known it was the right arm. And Mike Enos has really kicked this into high gear. But here's Mongo holding his ground. That timing. I think he got him with the elbow on top of the head. Oh, and he tells everybody, hey, it's okay. He even hit it himself that time, did Mongo, sending Mean Mike Enos in. 3-point stance. There's the explosion off of the scrimmage line, we've come to know.
And there's a man playing with pain. Sorry, Tony.
Yeah, you're not kidding, he is. And he's going to sock him in, it looks like.
Tried for the tombstone pile driver. Enos was obviously well prepared, countered the move with a knee lift.
That tombstone, he is known as his end zone spike. That time Enos gets him in the corner, pins him in with a left-handed lariat. Mongo, oh boy, Mongo just dazed, could not even get to his feet, enabling Enos to kick him in the back. The cover, Enos, very arrogant cover, and obviously not going to keep Mongo down with that. One of the most successful athletes to make the transition from the gridiron to the squared circle in the history of our sport. Of course, legendary names like Big Cat Ernie Ladd, Chief Wahoo McDaniel made the transition. But Steve McMichael ranks right up there with him. Of course, the longevity, obviously, not as long as those guys. But in a short span, former U.S. champion, and not many people can say that. And he is blood and guts as tough as they come. And look at this. He's actually hitting the man with that arm.
Well, at least in terms of offense, he certainly doesn't seem to be favoring it at all, Tony.
We'll try that spike again.
No.
With ease, he lifts up Enos.
Good night.
You're right, Brian. Not going to get up from that.
Wow.
Man, what if they, well, who knows the damage done to that leg?
Yeah, it's very serious, we understand, and we will keep you abreast on the prediction of Randy Savage.
Look at that, Tony, making the sign to the crowd of the horsemen. What a reaction here in Philadelphia.
And we're going to go to the replay. There you see the horsemen forever, our Thunderburst slam of the night. And Steve McMichael. Let's be calling for a poster here from one of the fans. We're going to go to a replay here in just a second. Here it is.
You see him taking us out. Hits him right in the kneecap, takes him over. He's got him up in that tombstone pile driver. Puts him right where he wants him. And there's your winner. He's back, bad arm and all. Steve Mongo McMichaels gets the 1-2-3.
Our Thunderburst Slam of the night brought to you by Cineburst Gum. Bite the burst with Cineburst fans tonight. United States champ Goldberg will certainly turn this crowd on and a whole lot more, including the Giant in action and Fit Finley and much more when we come back live on Thunder here on TBS.